apologies for the wait. People are screaming for the butcher's blood again. No sooner have we broken up one mob than another forms. Thankfully, all have been amenable to reason, thus far. But it is no concern of yours. We must speak of the men Arenvald and his comrades apprehended in the peaks.
By their uniforms, the captives were first judged to be Imperial troops. But after further investigation, their true identities came to light. I dare say you remember Yuyu Hassi and Laurentius, the fugitives who conspired with Captain Ilbert in the Crystal Brave's betrayal. Aye, well, it would seem they followed him all the way to the Wall. It was they who orchestrated the slaughter of the Resistance fighters prior to the Griffin's infernal ritual.
Were it in your hands, how would you punish these men? Hear, hear. There is no more fitting sentence for the perpetrators of such a massacre, and that is but one of their crimes. In any event, I thank you for your honesty. When the time comes for the Alliance to pass judgment, I'll see that your opinion is heard. Well, that concludes our business here. But there is more I would say. Walk with me. I bear a share of the blame for Ilbert's atrocities. Had I openly supported the cause of Alamegan liberation, he might not have felt driven to do what he did. Things could have been different, and I'm sorry they aren't. But even after all that has happened, my homeland is free. With the Scions and the Alliance at their side, my countrymen have reclaimed what many thought lost forever. Under her new leadership, I have every confidence that Alamigo will emerge from the shadow of the Empire and rise once more to greatness. Which means my work here is done. Soon I will return to Uldar and take my place at the Sultana's side.
Father.
I'll not deny there's a part of me that wants to stay. The same part that contemplated renouncing my rank and joining you as a wandering sellsword. But I pledged my blade to Nanamor, and I will not betray that oath.
Is this truly what you want, Father?
It is. Ever has my sword been hers to command, and ever shall it remain. Thank you for lending an ear. When all the rest are clamoring for me to stay, I trust you'll send me on my way.
thank you all for coming. I am Lys Hext, and I speak for the Resistance. Among you are village elders, refugee leaders, envoys from the Ananta and the Kikern. You've come from every corner of Girabania to help decide the future of Alamigo. But before that, I want to ask you a question. What was the first thing you noticed when you came in? For me, it was that empty throne. It has no one to sit on it now. No viceroy, no king. Would any of you like to take their place? Or should someone else sit there? Then let's sit here in a circle, as equals, and I hope, as friends.
Expertly done. Lys has removed monarchy as a choice early in the game and positioned them to consider a joint government. All things considered, I would say events have got off to a fine start.
And that is Alagana's stance on the matter.
Thank you, Regenfred. Another vote in favor. Next, let's hear from Shanti of the Kaliana. Tell us, how do your people feel about the idea of a republic?
The Ananta wish only that those who dwell within Gir Abania devote themselves to our faith. You shall all worship Sri Lakshmi! Lady of Bliss, grace us once more with your beauteous visage!
We're allowed through the door.
We can worry about the how of it later. We need to evacuate these people right now, or the Primal will make thralls of them all.
It's up to us.
See us all enthralled.
Then then they're going to be sorely disappointed. We have the Warrior of Light and Arenvold to shield us.
Aye, but they can't well defend your guests and attack the Primal, can they? We're stuck on the back foot.
All right, I think I have an idea. Keep these people safe, General. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Thank you. shall free you from your hate!
Damn it all! It's only a matter of time before we miss one.
What of it? Do you want to kill this thing or not?
Your soul's way heavy.
it! We beat her!
What is this? I'm only gonna say this once. The Ananta just summoned their primal in the throne room. My friends are fighting her, but they need help. They need someone with the Echo, and by the gods, I wish I had it, but I don't. I told you before that you still had time, but things have changed. I need your answer now. You can end it like Xenos, or you can fight for Alamigo. Your choice.
Seven hells. It's her, the Butcher.
It's done. Take me back to my cell.
You are not forgiven. Not you. You, I will never forgive. I will thank you. For standing against a primal and saving us from servitude, you have my thanks.
fine spot to contemplate the heavens. The meeting is over. The envoys have chosen to instate a government model on Ishgard's House of Commons, a ruling body of representatives elected by the people. It is a fair decision, and one which signals the end of my part in all this. But I would gaze upon Ghirabania's stars one last time before I leave. Forget something. Your Grace, there was no word.
Rauburn Aldin, you are hereby dismissed as General of the Immortal Flames and relieved of your seat on the Syndicate.
But, Your Grace...
Rauburn, I am no longer a child. Stay here in your homeland. Work with your brethren. Rebuild Alamigo.
You desire to stand alone. I understand, but remember what happened.
I remember full well the consequences of my naivety. And thus did I consult at length with a most trusted advisor ere I embarked upon this course.
A most trusted advisor? And what of me? Am I no longer deserving of your confidence?
What trust can there be between us when you withhold the truth from me? Did you think me oblivious to the anguish in your eyes when you spoke of returning to Uldar? For years and years, we have trusted one another. Yet now you refuse to confess your heart's desire?
I swore an oath to you that day on the sands. I pledged my sword.
And it has served me well. But in Pippin you have forged a new sword, as sharp and deadly as the blade you bequeathed him. I will show you a Sultana who can wield every weapon at her disposal, including Lolorito and his monetarist cronies. So follow your heart, please. You are home. You are free.
Nanamo. I...
Smile for me, Rauburn. I would have this parting be a joyous one.
Thank you, Your Grace. It has been an honor to serve you and Uldar.
Tomorrow you will serve Alamigo and fight for the good of all Eorzea. Am I understood?
Yes, Your Grace.
Thanks for shielding us from Lakshmi, you two. If you hadn't been there, the rest of us would be worshipping her by now.
You're kind to include me, Lise. But we both know who did most of the work. I could scarce keep track of the battle, let alone land at Elimblor. No shame in admitting it. The Warrior of Light has put far better men than me in the Shade.
Did I mention that I encountered the Sultana in the palace? It would seem Her Grace has come to Girabania to oversee the final stages of her relocation project. She was in search of General Aldin, and I directed her to the rooftop garden. I do hope you were still there.
Are you in the habit of gossiping about the affairs of royalty, Master Leveilleur?
Certainly not, Your Grace. I was merely informing my companions.
Be at ease, Alfano. Twas only a jest. But I must yield the floor to Rauban. He has an important announcement to make.
As of yesternight, I have been relieved of my post in the Immortal Flames and the Syndicate both.
I shall be assuming my father's duties. And may I say that Tizona has never felt heavier upon my back.
Would seem I am in need of employment. Mayhap one of my old acquaintances can introduce me to a mercenary company or some such.
You may be getting on in years, Father, but you'd struggle to find a band of sellswords who wouldn't snap your hand off. Your remaining hand.
Yes, the Bull of Alamigo need not be put out to pasture just yet.
Your Grace has developed a wicked edge to her humor, and you, Pippin, would do well not to laugh when the future may hold the same for you.
So, does this mean you're staying?
Aye. That seems to be the way of it. I would be glad to aid you in rebuilding our nation, if you'll have me.
If, he says. Welcome home, Rauban.
Well, that was unexpected. Though you seem distinctly unsurprised. Either you're more astute than I give you credit for, or I'm losing my touch. In any event, one thing is certain. Alamigo will rejoice at the homecoming of her dearest son.